we're not in some weird alternate universe where Sue plays.
Not yet, anyway. Now, let's get into this game.
All right, so now we're properly placed in the precinct, and we do have Sue playing Zerg. It's so funny because when we were watching that TVT, Sue, he rallied his SCV out. So, like, even though he wanted the game made, he was like, oh, maybe the game won't be remade and I'll have to play Terran. In that case, I better build a supply. At least I want to be ready for it.
Yeah, so, yeah, we saw Sue. Asshole makes you play your off-race.
All right, Felipe, why don't we go ahead and funny guys. Well, one funny guy and one machine.
All right, spawning in the bottom right-hand corner, sadly not playing Terran, our victor of the last show match, currently tied up 1-1, our blue Zerg, it's Sue.
And his opponent, who is Zerg, it is going to be Innovation. Yeah, I mean, honestly, if Sue plays Terran, I want to see Innovation. That's what I want to see.
They just both swap?
Yeah, I mean, why not, right? You might as well, you know, have fun with this. You're not in a GSL, you know, bracket match. This is a Polygon Invitational, and that's what we want. We want to see these players go, like, butt crazy and just do something completely weird.
That would really be something, like...
Yeah.
Somebody should do, like, a tournament like that, where everybody, whoever...
Like, plays a different race?
You have to play your opponent's race.
Oh, God.
So it, like, stays, like, random? So all the mirror matches are actually good games, but then you have to, like, change up your race constantly.
Oh my God, that would be so funny. I would love to see that happen. Like, what if, like, next game we see Sue and Innovation play, like, a PvP, and we're just like, what is going on here? Is this real life?
Now, we do see a couple of Zerglings here going to try and delay that command center, and going straight into a third CC is Innovation.
Oh, this is really,
too.
Yeah, no, so this is an interesting decision. This is interesting decision from Innovation to build this command center. Low ground natural, which means Innovation doesn't care if Sue sees that he's going for a 3cc. Now, here's the thing, Felipe. We've already seen Bunny do this on New Kirk Precinct. We saw him do a 3cc build, and what did Sue do? He cut off drones, didn't saturate his third base, went for a Ravager Link all in, and just destroyed Bunny before he was even ready for a proper defense. So we could be seeing that again from Sue. He knows how to respond to this.
I mean, he could do that, but maybe we'll see something different. Who knows? Because Innovation, of course, is just an entirely different player from Bunny, and maybe that will force Sue to change up the style a little.
Yeah, but it was very effective what Sue did. Innovation's doing the exact same build right now with Stimpak on the way, Reactor Hellions pulling out, and then, of course, he's gonna, you know, go up to 3 racks now and just get ready for a bio transition. But that's the thing, like, Sue knows exactly what's going on. Bunny did the exact same thing. He had a very strong Ravager thing all the timing that just completely decimated Bunny. So, could be seeing the same thing from Sue. It's all going to depend on this third. The minute this third patch tree finishes, we're going to see what Sue decides to do. Now, we do not see a Roach Warren from Sue. We see double evolutionary chambers on him, which means, no, we're not going to be seeing a Roach Ravager. So it's going to be a little bit of a different build, and I'm very interested to see how Sue is planning on transitioning differently this game rather than the one that he played against Bunny, because he knows that it worked out well the first time. So his decision to not go for it, that he wants to play a different game than against Bunny, and it may just have to do with the fact that he understands Innovation's playstyle and thinks, well, there's no way Innovation's going to.
Now, we see Sue going for a pretty quick flare on top of this, on top of his Evo Chambers, getting 1-1 melee and Carapace upgrades there. So are we going to see maybe some Lingbane Muta off of this skin?
Oh no, we are absolutely going to, just because you see the layer coming in, we see the fourth hatchery coming, Sue's main base. So this means that Sue is getting ready for He's getting ready for that exact, you know, unit composition that we know is the exact thing to do in TV. You get Lins and Banelings, you get Mutas, and you fight against MMM. And that is exactly what we are going to be seeing here. Now, this is entirely up to soO to see whether or not he can out macro Innovation or deal enough damage that Innovation's third CC doesn't get him ahead in the game. It's all up to soO at this point. He knows that Innovation went for a quick 3 CC build. If he allows Innovation to just comfortably macro up with a bunch of SCVs and get out a sick economy and get out a ridiculously strong bio army, then soO will be in a lot of trouble because the division is very well known for this. Very well known. Oh, hold on, there, Lunch
Team! And we do have a little bit of attack in here coming in here. Zerg get a very good surround here, but the medevacs are going to lift up and fly away. Is going to cancel that force base by soO, though, forcing him a little bit behind.
This was a great move by Innovation, not losing his Marines more than he needs to. Got the cancel on the hatchery, forcing soO to take that fourth base a little later. This was a good move by Innovation. Then he picked up on his medevacs and moved out. He didn't apply any more pressure after that. He retreated and is waiting for his reinforcements. This is a very good move right now by Innovation. soO needs to be aware of this. He needs to like send a limb forward and find out where Innovation's army is, or he's just gonna lose his fourth base to get this attack.
Looks like he's gonna know where Innovation's army is anyway, because Innovation is pushing forward and destroying all of this creep and going right for this fourth hatch as well. Widowmine burrowing down in there as well, providing a pivot in case he needs to pull on back. Zerglings swarming in a few Banelings with those arts slow base, and those Marines are too far out for those Banelings to reach them. A few Zerglings are gonna move in though and clean up most of these guys. Widow mines have already fired, which means there is no one to move. A couple more Widow mines though are going to take out a couple of Mutalisk, I think, was there, and a couple of Zerglings as well. Muta's now chasing down these medevacs, one of them surviving with like literally 1 HP.
And this is getting to the point where now Innovation is going to have to stay at home and defend against these Mutas. And what Sue's gonna want to do is use these Mutas to force Innovation to stay at home and defend as long as possible while he gets up his fourth base and establishes a late game army composition. So soO, these Mutas are crucial. He can't lose them. He needs to fly around constantly and keep Innovation at home defending. And Innovation knows that that's what soO is trying to do. So he needs to defend quickly and then get out an army and just go and just kill soO. This is a very dangerous timing right now for soO. He already had to cancel his fourth base twice. He's running on 3-base economy versus 3-base economy. And in TBZ, when you're on the same number of bases, the Terran always wins. So this is entirely up to soO right now to make the right decisions to keep Innovation defending at home as much as possible. He absolutely cannot allow this fourth base to die again, or Innovation is just going to steamroll all over soO.
Now soO is just up here in the top of this map, wait, just kind of hovering over all of Innovation stuff, waiting for +2/+2 to complete. That stuff is ready now though, so he may be sending his army down, but +2/+2 is ready for Innovation as well, and it looks like he is gonna move on in towards Sue's base. And that's exactly what he's doing. The scan going down, these creep tumors being cleared up, and soO is realizing that now is his time to attack. Warming in, but this supply depot wall is a little too much. He does break through it, but there is too much by the time he does already there to stop. Nothing there to allow, to stop Innovation from stopping him to push on.
Yeah, Felipe, soO is in a lot of trouble. His only window to deal damage to Innovation. Scary army out, and is getting 3-3. Very soon, Innovation's army is going way too strong for soO to do anything about it. And as you can see, Innovation is moving up into this. This is a position as a Zerg that you cannot allow the Terran player to take, because it's just so hard for Zerg to move in afterwards. You can burrow your Widow Mines and take the high ground advantage and force Zerg to fight in a very narrow pathway. And it's very hard for Zerg to get conquered. So we're going to see a battle here very soon, but Innovation does have the advantage.
Now it looks like soO is going to roll in. Banelings moving in are going to get some decent hits off Widowmine. They're barely surviving with 4 HP, and it looks like soO is gonna roll on up here, attacking from both directions, moving in those veins, moving in those Zerglings. Mutalith flying in on top of all of this, and it looks like Innovation is gonna be cleared out of that position.
Yeah, a bit of a mistake here from Innovation, not having to deal with this army. But he is going to back off a little bit and force soO to retreat. So now while this is going on, he needs to keep pumping out as many Widowmines as possible. He's already got the reactor on the factory. He needs to pump out Widowmines. He needs to establish his fourth base comfortably. He needs to make sure he doesn't die to any sort of counterattack the next time he tries to move out. Innovation did a great job applying pressure. He didn't lose his entire army. He was able to save a good portion of his army, because if he had lost that entire army, the game would have tilted completely in soO's favor. But he was able to keep his army alive. He retreated just in time, and now he has a chance to bring this game back into his favor. soO has to be very careful. He can't mess up his engagements here. He can't let the Widowmines kill too many of his bane.
And he is going to pick off a Widowmine there. Innovation scans. Looks like soO is going to move forward. Get some good bangling hits off, and he's going to just keep pulling back, not wanting to engage Innovation off of creep.
If you see that soO already has an Ultralisk Cavern up, and he's already got the Chitinous Plating on the way, this means Innovation now can no longer Marine pump out Liberators. He has to get out Ghost. He has to get ready for that late transition for a 12 minutes into the game. If soO can hold off this attack, he's in a great position.
Looks like soO may just be able to. Mutalix flying above, taking out multiple medevacs there, as well as these Zerglings just continuing to poke in. Nothing huge, not wanting to throw away his entire army yet, but he is going to kill whatever Innovation sends that over sends. Good Baneling hit right there, taking out a decent clump of Marine. And Innovation is still just extending with the U of those guys. Mutalith's gonna fly and maybe take out a medevac. Not quite yet, though.
Okay, the ultras are out now for soO, and he needs to get a good number of his ultras before he tries to engage the Sonic.
Looks like Innovation is going to take this opportunity, though. Stim right on top of it. Going to fall back, though. Few Widowmite hits. Almost everything that soO had there is taken out, and Innovation just stepped right on in. This is done for.
Yeah, this is exactly what I was talking about. Shouldn't have. Explaining wasn't even done for his ult.
The ultra may just save this with some mutalists up top as well, taking out those medevacs. Beautiful hold with those transfuses by soO there.
Okay, so now Innovation has to retreat. Ultra, so he's gonna have to retreat, get out Liberators. Oh no, he's getting Vipers. He's gonna go Vipers and I just gotta take care of the Overlords in here.
I mean, he is just kiting so well against the Ultras. Ultras are not that good if you don't have Zerglings and Banelings to support them on their own. They're just these big, keeping, slow things that just get shot up.
Yeah, no, you're right about that, and you can see he's just having trouble right now because Innovation is scanning and killing off all these creep tumors. If Zerg is not on creep, they have a hard time engaging the Terran army. And okay, so we do see Terran ship weapons coming in from Innovation, which means he should be getting ready to get out an army of Liberators. And we see another starport on the way, and we do see Liberators on the way. This is a great move from Innovation. This is the exact kind of army composition that he wants at this point in the game. He's already killed off soO's fourth base, so he knows he's in a good position. When you're on the same kind of economy as the Zerg opponent, you are almost always going to win, as I've stated before. So now soO needs to make sure, soO absolutely needs to make sure Innovation can't establish the fifth base. If Innovation gets this fifth base up and running, soO is in a lot of trouble. He is going to have trouble dealing with Liberators, and he's going to have trouble dealing with Innovation's army in general, because to deal with the Liberators, you need to get out of night. An economy that soO just cannot afford right now. He doesn't have the gas to get out corrupted.
Very good pickoff up here by the Mutalists on that full medevac there. Factory actually flying around here, scouting Sue's army, knowing that there's not much that can shoot up with it, but the Mutalists are gonna fly through, and that factory is done.
Yeah, no, this was a good move from Innovation.
Ooh, he's actually using that as an opportunity to move in on top of those guys. Not quite yet, though. Did not pull those mutas quite as far out as he wanted.
Yeah, the Widow Mines aren't really useful anymore at this point in the game, so it's okay to set the factory. You just need to get out more Liberators, and I would like to see a Ghost Academy coming so that you can do some snipes against these Ultras, just in case the Liberators don't do enough damage. So now we're going to see late game versus like 16 minutes into the game, both players trying to go up to 5 and 6 bases. So this is now up to engagement, micro, and decision making for these players.
A few Ultras getting fired upon there, but their Titanus plating is too much. They're not going to take too much damage there, but 8 Liberators fly in, and that's a whole lot of Liberation.
Oh my god, here we go, we're gonna have an engagement here.
Ooh, the Mutalisks flying in, they're gonna take out everything in the air along with Corruption support. Meanwhile, Ultralisks, Banelings, all rolling in, taking out as much as they can on the ground, but it looks like Innovation has taken this engagement.
Oh, Innovation just had more than enough to take care of Sue's attack, and now the Corruptors are out for Stoop, but he needed them much quicker. He needed them about 5 minutes earlier during that engagement where all the Liberators were out up and running. And if he loses his fourth base again, then he's gonna this is just one of their pockets by Innovation.
He's just going to keep on building up his stuff, building more army, but he feels he has it. Like right now, he is going to send in a few more Zerglings, a few more Banelings, rolling up the Corruptors as well, taking out both all the Liberators. There, that last Liberator's gonna go down as well. And it looks like he may have just held off this attack.
He had just enough to fight off and force Innovation to retreat, but if you look at the supply, it's 134 to 126, they're almost even. But now Innovation is in a great spot. He killed off the fifth base of soO, and Dale dealt a lot of damage on the fourth base of soO. And soO needs gas, a lot of gas, to get the late game army composition he wants to care of Innovation's army, but it just doesn't have the gas for it. If you look at Sue's fourth base here at the 11 o'clock, 1 o'clock position, he has no extractors up.
And it looks like we have a little bit of engagement here, too. Maybe not wanting to push too far off free, but no, he is going to go for it. The Liberators are up, though. Just 2 Ultras are not going to be enough to hold that off.
And now soO realizes he is in lot of trouble. He just doesn't have the economy ready to take on Innovation's strong and powerful army, and Innovation is just keeps getting more and more bases, and so he can't stop it.
And another little engagement coming in here, and there is just no support for the Ultras, they're the only thing on the ground, which means that these Marines can just kite them, and not much is going to get done on that front. One Liberator here, the one health Liberator.
Just an SCV.
With an SCV right below it.
Yeah, you can repair. Well, the Liberator's like, why aren't you repairing? Die.
Damn you, SCV.
Oh, we got another Yeager here for the same.
And we have a whole lot of Zerglings flooding in here. We have Ultras on the ground. Finally, the one health Liberator does die. And that SCV is going to get nibbled to death by a couple of Zerglings as well. Just in this little payback for never repairing that Liberator.
Yeah, I can only imagine that that Liberator is something that just, you know, taking a little time out of its life to repair it.
And a little Zergling run by coming in, we're gonna pressure this baseline Innovation. And a still just flying around with the Corruptors, picking off Medivacs, picking off the Liberator. It's a very good play on the part of soO, but he is just still very behind in supply.
Yes, he is an Innovation. Innovation needs to make sure to he's kind of deeply off grid, and now he's losing all of his expensive
hit. Very good engagement by Innovation. He is very far ahead in supply. A couple of burrowed Banelings, though! Are they gonna blow up? Not quite as good as they could have been, though.
It's such a Marauder-heavy army composition. The Marauders are more than enough to tank even burrowed Banelings right now. So even though soO is pulling out little tricks here and there to try to get himself back into this game, he just can't out macro Innovation, who is comfortably mining off of 3 fully functioning bases right now. And very soon soO is going to run out of money because he just doesn't have the hatcheries.
Now Sue continuing to move in with these run-bys, just trying to pressure Innovation, trying to keep him on his side of the map, because Sue knows he is behind. He knows he does not have the economy Innovation does. There is no doubt about that. So he's just trying to keep get by himself as much time as possible.
Look at the supply difference here, Felipe. Innovation is about to be maxed out, and Sue can't even hit 150 at this point.
It is just terrifying. More Bruin Baneling right there. One Baneling going up, and it can't kill the other one.
Innovation's like, I've had enough of it. Time to figure out where these Bruin Banelings are.
I mean, that's just one of those things that's going to keep Innovation on his toes, though.
Alright, here we go.
Another drop coming down here. And here, while the Zerg army moves in on top of Innovation, so Liberators dying left and right, as well as these medevacs to these corrupted Banelings rolling in. Zerglings running in, killing a lot of stuff. Gonna try and even up the supply, but it is not a good enough trade on the part of Sue. Sue is so far behind in supply, and game number. I'm not supposed to count, but I think it's game number 3 goes to Innovation.
Game number 3 does go to Innovation, indeed. If you notice, Felipe, in the engagement, Sue had no ultras. That's how poor Sue was. He just didn't have the economy necessary to get out those late-game ultras that he needed in order to be able to take care of Innovation's army, and Innovation was just too far ahead. Like I said, Sue couldn't get up to one even 150 supply during that last engagement, and Innovation was maxed out. There was just nothing that Sue could do to get himself back into the game. At that point, it was just Innovation's game to lose. All right, Felipe, so we are going to go ahead and go into the next game. Based on what we've seen, how do you feel about Sue's chances about making a comeback?
I don't know. I think he can do it. Sue is such a good player that I have faith in him that he can earn his title as the dominant Zerg. If he can defeat Innovation, I think he can do it.
Sue is a very strong player, absolutely more than capable of bringing this back into his favor. He's capable of grabbing a victory here in game 4 and tying up the score 2-2. But the thing with Innovation and Sue is that what I'm noticing for both players and their movements and their engagements is they understand each other so darn well. Innovation knows exactly where to go and when to hit Sue, while Sue knows exactly how to move his army around so that he doesn't have to take any unnecessary engagements. Both players just really understand each other so well that it's just hard to decide what to do, because these are two players who are just so familiar with each other's playstyles.